Have you ever found yourself just playing an older style Call of Duty game and looking at some of the features inside of that game, wishing they were in the newest ones? Yeah, that was me too, while I was playing Advanced Warfare the other day. And I started to think about some of my favorite features from this game that never happened to make it into any future Call of Duty games. This can be said for a lot of different things out there, so I started to jot down a list, and today I'm going to be bringing you 5 things Call of Duty Removed that I really miss. And we're going to start with number 5. COD points. Yeah! COD points! No, not those COD points. These COD points from Black Ops 1. You could play matches and you'd earn COD points. They'd be used to unlock attachments, camouflages, and things like that. It was always very satisfying to use these COD points to go through wager matches and, of course, earn even more to unlock that 50,000 point golden camouflage. And that brings in the next question. Where the hell did our wager matches go? I'd really like to see those return as well. I cannot tell you guys how many nightmares I still have to this very day thinking about some of those high roller matches I had. I remember a few months ago I made a video talking about how it would be pretty cool to have high roller matches or just wager matches in general. Instead of using COD points, we use actual keys that we earn in game. That could be interesting. Moving on to that number 4 spot, we're talking about a feature located in Advanced Warfare Multiplayer, and that would be the speed reload. Now, you could call me dumb in the comment section if you want, but for the longest time, I thought this was a glitch, and that's because I have obsessive reload disorder, and that's because every time I would reload my gun, no matter what Call of Duty game it was, I would tap the reload button as many times as I can just to make sure that I'm reloading the gun. If you do that in Advanced Warfare, you will do a speed reload where you drop your entire magazine you're currently using and top it up with a brand new magazine. Meaning, if you had 24 rounds in the magazine you just speed reloaded, you just lost 24 rounds of ammunition. This was so detrimental to my gameplay, and I didn't understand why it was happening, so I eventually made a video talking about the glitch, and I don't know what they need to do to fix it, and I was quickly corrected by some people in the comment section, and now that I think about it, I don't know if I ever removed that video, so if you guys ever find it, enjoy that piece of embarrassment. But anyway, after learning how to control the reload, and of course my finger spasms so I don't speed reload all the time, I actually started to use it to my advantage, waiting until I only had a few rounds in the magazine before speed reloading and, you know, subsequently being able to reload faster. It was definitely a nice feature, and after getting used to it over the course of a year, it was something that I was kind of sad to see go. Once we got into Black Ops 3, I kind of missed it, but to each their own. I'd really like to know what you guys think about the speed reloading in the comment section below. Moving into that number 3 spot, we're going to talk about support streaks, more importantly in COD Ghosts. At least this is where I think they were most beneficial. The streak that I have in mind is the support squad member. Now, I don't know if you guys remember, but it's the little guy that runs around with the shield. He can pick up weapons out of your weapons crate, which I really liked as well, part of the support class. And I really love the fact that he was able to help you capture objectives. This is something that not many people know, but if you called in a support squad member, they would follow you around the map, and while you're capturing, they would count as a teammate and also capture for you. It would also put an additional capture on the scoreboard for you, so you could earn so much more XP at the end of the round. It was my little way of playing and earning XP, and it was also nice to know and have that comfort if I'm playing a game of domination solo, I don't have to rely on random teammates to help me capture flags anymore. I could have my support squad member help me capture a flag and, of course, defend me in my time of need, which is pretty damn cool. It would be really nice to see something like that come back to Call of Duty, but I know as the years go on and on, a lot more people ask for more powerful streaks, and I know that support's just getting kicked in the ass, but for me at least, I always love to support my team with ballistic vests, UAVs, counter UAVs. It was always nice to have that strafing run come over and take out streaks. That was just my favorite category, and it was pretty much what I used a majority of the time while playing COD Ghosts. Also, whatever happened to the specialist streaks? I mean, think about it. Running around the map, getting kills consecutively would give you more and more perks until eventually you were specialist. You had the specialist bonus. You earned more XP. You had all the perks in the game. Thinking about that just makes me wonder why I ever went away. It was such a cool system, and I'd love to see it return. taking that number two spot, and I know it's kind of soon to put this on the list because it just happened last year, but I would really love to see the paint shop and paint jobs come back for weapons. The only time we've ever seen it is in Black Ops 3, and like I said, I know we've only had one Call of Duty since, but it would still be nice to see that make a return. Having the ability to just be as unique and creative as you can be on your weapon was really nice. Not worrying about a specific camouflage coming out of the supply drop system, and just worrying about your own creativity in your brain. Over the past few years, we have seen so many incredibly talented artists make some awesome paint jobs on weapons in Black Ops 3. Some of these people being Magic Sista, N97, just to name a few, but they have created pieces of art that you can kill people with. And that's what I really love about the entire system. As creative as you can be, you can have anything you want on the weapon. It's not just full of dicks and tits anymore. It's actual art on your gun. And I think that that's really nice. I also think we should bunch in the emblem creator in this as well. I think an emblem creator should just be standard for every Call of Duty moving forward. All right, finally taking that number one spot, and after careful deliberation with myself, I feel like theater mode should take this position. It's something that people ask about every single year for Call of Duty. It doesn't matter if it's a Sledgehammer, a Treyarch, or an Infinity Ward game. The question always comes up at some point: will theater mode be included? Now, theater mode is something that we've really only been getting from Treyarch for the past few years, and they've done an amazing job with that. It was perfect in Black Ops 3, and I utilized it a lot in many of my Black Ops 3 videos that required a more cinematic tone. But here we are in 2017, and a majority of the studios will tell you that they're not introducing a theater because the consoles we're playing on right now have their own built-in recording. But to me, at least, theater isn't just about recording. Theater to me is about creativity, creative freedom, and being able to explore, and of course look at the finite details on maps that you wouldn't be able to in the action, and of course going back and replaying cool moments from different angles. And a lot of the time I would go into private match and I would set up really cool moments and have that as my thumbnail, or I would go in and test things for the Five Things series, and it was like, it was super easy to just be able to hop into the theater mode, say I recorded something really cool, and have that ready to go on like the snap of a finger. You can't do that with the built-in recording software with the PS4 and the Xbox One. If you could, that would be revolutionary, but you can't. It records what you see. Now, just being 100% with you guys, I'm not going to sit here and pretend I know what the daily struggles are of a developer working on Call of Duty, because I don't know. Especially for something like theater mode, I'm sure it takes a ton of man hours. It most likely takes a ton of resources to run, because you really gotta think about it. You're recording the game that you're playing, and while you're playing, it's background recording everything you're doing and what every other player is doing. Plus, you think about all the data that's being stored. It's probably a technological nightmare for someone that works at one of these studios. So yes, in the end, it's probably easier if it's just not there, but for me, and I know a lot of other people who appreciate the work that Treyarch does on their theater modes, it would be nice to see something like that implemented in every Call of Duty game moving forward. Even if it was really bare bones, kind of like the Modern Warfare 3 version, I would really appreciate any type of theater mode. But who knows? We don't really know what they're going to do moving forward. A couple of honorable mentions that I would like to put in this final portion of the video right here. I would like to say, in regards to returning things, I kind of liked the customizable streaks. I know that they're kind of semi in Call of Duty Infinite Warfare with different rarities of streaks, but I like the fully customizable ones in Advanced Warfare. Being able to choose what pieces and parts you add to it was really kind of cool. I wouldn't mind seeing that again. I just wish it wasn't part of the pick 10 or pick 13 system, meaning we could choose as many parts as we want and have a score that just keeps going higher and higher and higher until we can eventually earn that streak and completely wipe out anybody that's there. But anyway, guys, that is going to conclude today's video. I hope you all enjoyed. I know it was a little bit different, a little bit out of right field, but I was playing Advanced Warfare the other day, remembered about the speed reload, and of course I was playing Ghosts and remembered about the squad member, and it's like, these are all things that I would love to see come back. And I just wanted to make a video about it. So anyway, guys, I hope you all enjoyed. If you did, make sure to click that like button down below. Don't forget to subscribe for more videos coming each and every day. If you're subscribed already, please don't forget to click that notification button. YouTube sucks ass when it comes to notifying my subscribers when my videos go live, so if you click that notification button, you'll always be updated on when I'm live. Anyway, guys, until tomorrow, I will see ya. Peace!